Okay, so where was I? I need to import stuff for make sure that's on revibrate. Bones, I need to import mesh bones, and I need to for the model. Okay. Let's see if I can. Mesh loader, we need to import mesh bone weights, import. Okay, there's two things. I need to import. I'm not sure what I need to import. I don't know. Okay, perhaps. Okay, I need to rework this. I need to get the entire scene skeleton. From that, I can determine. Okay, yeah. So I need like a new simp scene loader. Armature. And it'll return a vector of something. Armature node, probably, of some sort. Armature nodes. What is on a let's go to oh nice if I can died class list SourceForge is just offline great just when I okay. Let's go to this. Thank you. Okay, mflags, root node. Is it based on root nodes? Is it like an AI node? Probably. Okay, what's in a node? Name, transformation, parent, children, number of meshes per node? What? Oh, okay. Number of, okay. Okay, not really going to bother with this, but what I do care about is the nodes, and it's the subnodes of children. Okay. Okay, we'll do something like that. This is an AI node, so it's just that and children and the offset and transformation. Okay. So we'll make a string. We'll have a number of children. The number of children, num children. Children offset. And the transformation matrix. Like that. Okay, we have include standard int, and we need a string as well. I can't hold down the shift button. Scene, we got that. Oh, yes, the name of the node as well. Okay, we go through. This is based on the root node. Yeah, whatever. We'll just base it off the root node for now. Do some finer tuned stuff later. I don't really know the size of it yet, but we will be returning it. Total offset equals 1. I want to do a recursive function then, actually. Probably. So import. I'll need like a internal function. The offset we're currently at, would it be 32t total? Okay. If we start with that, and then we pass in current offset. No, we don't even need that. If we, okay. Armature node. Like that. Or we say, we'll create a new node for armature. Or we can actually probably just add it to the end, right? Because I'm adding myself here. No. I need to do something smarter than that. I need to, rather than doing it on the way, I'm going to have to, okay. The offset I'm at, then we'll have like a TRP total offset, which we'll return back. And we'll have the full armature node star p armature node. Great. Where like the p armature point at the armature at offset. So we're always at the beginning. Equals armature node. Dot name equals what node we're on? P node name, right? M name. Children equals. Dot, it's not like num children, isn't it? Ah. What is it? Children offset? Okay, if, we first of all need to make sure if it's the end. Otherwise becomes P, the current total offset minus the other offset for zero. If there's dot, of course. And dot transform equals. I need to figure out a way to transform to rebuild those. Otherwise, total offset will equal, or plus e, it'll be incremented by number of children we have. I'm trying to do like a tree in linear memory, where each node has an offset further into the memory block array to determine, oh crap. There we go. Start at one, and we do like an import armature tree. For the root node, starting at one. Yeah, we start at one. And in total offset. And then it's armature. Stop data. Of course, I'm going to have to make sure that this is the right size, which means I'm going to have to go through like all the nodes and determine the Okay, we'll do that in a moment. First of all, let's finish this off. Okay, so for all the children. Children offset. It'll be this. No, it won't be this anymore. Ooh. Because it'll be incremented here. Offset. Plus child, and then we got p total offset and p armature. And we go in recursively through the tree. Now I need a way to transfer from one type to another. Do this, and then, come on. Yeah, I'm at 4. No? 8 tricks, 4x4. Let's see how this is laid out. Is this column first? Column major or row major? Here we go, column major. And I'm pretty sure GLM is. Let's bring this up. Is it row major? Column major. What? Wait, hold on. What's going on? Okay, AI matrix 4x4 is row major, not column major. And GLM is. GLM. What the hell is this? This isn't what I'm looking at. This is old. Okay, they're column major. So I need to transform it. And then this. Oh, that's the C++, and that's the C. Yeah. Okay. Cute. All right. sorry, not return dist. Okay, then we return destination, and that gives us a 2GLM at 4 of that. Sorry? I node. Oh, right. Okay, great. Lost it. Give it to me. I node. Name transformation. The AI string. What is AI? Is there like a data member I can work with? Data up to 1,000 characters. Or C string. Just I can use that. Okay. Or is there like a standard string version? No, there isn't. Table design. Armature nodes. Yeah. I'm going to. Number, okay, we can do return, okay. Recursively void our 132T. From an AI node. Except we'll just do this recursively. So you and 32T count equals 1. Or actually we'll just say it's like nodes. Be a bit more specific. Very nice. Go through the nodes, children. From node and children from node. So we get the entire count of child nodes from this guy. Then we can import the tree into this pre-sized vector that we have. Okay, I only have 2 right now anyways. I don't really think it's going to make much of a difference at the moment. Let's bring it in. loading. At the end, we're going to do armature. Scene armature. Hey, it sucks. It didn't even make it out. What went wrong? Import. Okay, went deep in the armature tree and then died. That's great. So 5123. Okay. Even though there's like only two of these? Hold on, there's two nodes, right? Or, well, I'll find out in a second. Five of them. Okay, that makes sense. They're all blank right now. We go inside the root node. That's great. Start on this one. PR armature. P node, M name of scene. Okay, yeah. We have two children with whatever that transformation is. We have five children. Huh? On the same. Oh, we're on the same. We're on the same node, so it'd never end. Be offset? No, it'd be child. Would that be offset? Yes, that would be offset. Let's have a look at how this works. Let's make sure I'm not going crazy. So first of all, we're on the node. We're on the root node. That's great. Go inside. We're on the armature node. That's great. We're on the armature bone node. Okay. Armature bone one node instead of zero, I presume. We're on the cube node. And then we leave. Okay. Oh, it actually worked as well. Instead of crashing. So then I presume at this point, if I was to rerun it. Oh, I'm still running that. Scene armatures. So we got what? We got the cube, we got the armature bone, got nothing, got armature, nothing. The root has no children. That ain't right. Ain't right at all. Okay. So first of all, the first one in is, of course, The node I'm in is the root node, right? It says something. It says scene. So this should become, what's the offset? Offset is 1. Why is the offset 1? It shouldn't be. The total offset would be 1. Yeah. Because the next offset, non-reserved offset, would be 1. Okay. Yeah, great. The armature scene transform. We have two children starting at offset 1. So that means it'll be 1 and 2, which will, okay, let's see. Two children, so 1 and 2, armature and cube. He doesn't have any children, so he has no child offset. So this will be the mesh, the cube mesh that's being transformed. So this is something I would discard later. Otherwise, armature... He has 1 child. He's at offset 2. No. He'd be down here. Oh, yes. No. Children offset will be... Whoops. It'd be the offset from where he is. So... Offset of 2, 1, 2, goes down to here. He's got 1 child who's offset from him by 1. Right? It's, can I open this up in... This file is probably going to actually include animated cube blend file. Let's see what we've got. We got the cube, which is this stuff. We've got the pose, the armature, animation, pose, bone, and bone 1. Okay, so yeah. Armature, bone 1. Yeah, because go back. That's the first bone 0, and that's bone 1. That's offset from this guy. Yeah, okay. There we go. Okay. So I'm going to presume that I imported the scene armature correctly. I can prune. I can figure out a mechanism for pruning or leave it manually later, or some mixture of the two. Pruning bones that aren't actual bones, like the cube. That's obviously a leftover from Blender's modeling mechanism or whatever. Or that's the node of the actual mesh, not the whatever, stuff like that, blah 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 blah. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just conjecturing. What can we do then? Animations. Now it's part of. Scene, right? It's some kind of other material animation. Okay, here we go. All animations imported from the given file are listed here. The array is that size, so it is it's a scene-based thing, right? There's no other. No. Unless iMesh has something to do. No. It's very much a scene thing. No, actually, don't put anything there until I actually know what I'm going to require, because I may actually want to import these on an individual basis, much like meshes. So let's see what this is. An animation is a duration with ticks per second specified. Number of channels. Mesh animation. Okay, node animation versus mesh animation. Mesh morph. Okay, hold on. Okay, node animation. The bone node, which is affected by this animation channel, with keyframes of 3.0.1. Well, keys are absolute, not relative to the bone default pose. Scaling rotation, okay. What about mesh animation? Okay. Mesh morph. Okay. We'll do node-based animation for the moment. So that's the most simplest I can understand, I guess. So, 'cause at least if it's a node animation, then it can be reapplied to multiple skeletal or multiple armatures, that if they use the same armature, that is, like a human, like multiple human, a whole bunch of human characters all share the same armature, and thus you can apply multiple animations to that same armature. But like facial animations would be like mesh based, because like their facial, like their ma like in Team Fortress, like the actual characters' faces and mouth shapes and whatever face shapes are fairly different, so you need something more specific for those, and probably it's the same thing with mesh morph or morph mesh. So for the moment, I'll just do AI node animation. That's probably the only thing I can really figure out. So, I'll put it here for the moment. Animation. Start with that. Just give it a name. Name of the animation. Fantastic. With the basics of. Okay. And then node animation channels. Rotation keys, scaling keys. Okay. Okay. Node name, that. Okay. So it's a name. Node name. The node. And then we have the vectors of these keys. Rotation key. Nice. Starting to screw up. It's just what? A time and a value. Okay. Quaternion for value, and then this is probably the same thing, right? Quaternion key and okay, yeah, same thing. Okay. Not sure whether it's different node and oh yeah, each animation node channels is based on a node, and then that's all the keys for that node throughout the entire timeline of the animation. Okay, I can see this starting to come together in my mind. Not sure about this one. Default constant linear. Yeah, whatever. Okay. Okay, I think we can do that That looks okay. Animation, return, all this stuff. Okay. Let's go back to whatever this is, duration, and what have you. Okay, that's a start. No channels. We could just actually, add it as we go along. Channel equals 0, channels less than P animation, channels. Was it? Put this down for the moment. Got a new animation channel. Trying to think if I actually should try to like map these animations to the armature specifically, or just kind of have like free floating data, or do I want like a translation between the two? Maybe a translation layer will be best. Keep the data as separate as possible. We can link it together later. All right, especially if we're trying to do multiple. I don't really know what I'm doing, as usual. Okay. Mesh channel, sorry, not mesh channels. Just M channels. Channel dot M node name dot C string. What was it? No, not the whole line, just this. cancels that. And then we just want to like a p-channel that. Okay. And then in the node animation, we want to go through all the keys. Which will be a bit of a pain. For each key, specific node channel, channel dot position keys dot in place back, which is this. For key dot time. Keys k dot m value dot x, and we're going to do the same thing for y and z. Okay, then we end it up like that. For each channel, okay, we got all the position keys. Do the same thing for scaling. And we want to do similar for rotation. Rotation key. Yes. X, Y. No, it starts off with W. GLM. Quaternion. W, X, Y, Z. For rotation keys, scaling keys. Should be it. Oh, and then we want to add this to it. I mean, we'd have to map it later, but that would be it. Okay, let's see how this comes out. I have one animation. Scene. And animations zero. We've only got the one. There's absolutely no name, but it's 4 point whatever seconds. There's one tick per second. That's great. Armature bone, armature bone one. There's a couple position keys, there's a couple rotation keys, and there's scaling keys at different times with different values, I presume. Okay, this. Is there not even a name? There is no actual name to the animation, so I guess it makes a bit of sense then. It's not that bad, I suppose. Okay. Should probably actually split that up. It's not really part of the, like the this stuff isn't really specific to that. Bring it out. Okay. Don't need that. Do need that though. Struct include vector. That's enough of that. We're going to need the ability to interpolate between these as well. Scaling. If there's no position keys, just empty. If one, just return the first one. Otherwise, if time is before when this one actually starts. You also return, oh, okay. Or turn to set the first one again. Otherwise, we need to go into start at one. We go through. If time is less than the time we found, we break out. Otherwise, index equals I. Then we need to check if it's the last key, return with it. Otherwise, we're going to have to do some funky calculations based on index and index plus one. So, whatever the size, natural size of the processor is. So, double. Time, we need to find the time between the two. Next index.time minus animation position keys index dot time. Plus position minus start position times, going to cast it by float. Do we need to cast it by float? Yeah, we'll have to cast by float. Or do we even have to? Maybe we don't have to, actually. No, we're probably going to cast it. Okay, that start position and minus start position times the time between the frames. Start plus the time. Okay, yes. That looks awful. I think that's the gist of it. Now I just need to do it for this, for the others as well. Scaling. Yes. Okay. And we'll do the same thing for Quaternion. Now it's not that, it's a quaternion. But same thing. Well, nope. Down here is a quaternion. Yeah, okay. I'm just trying to think if like I can actually compact this down. I no, keep it accurate. I can compact it later. Okay. World's worst. Animation.cpp. Add that. We need to go to scene loader. We need to include need to include that for that. Okay, run around with that. Fantastic. Doing an hour 10. Okay. Pulled out scene armatures. I pulled out animation. I need the mesh bone information now. Like what parts of the armature it points at or uses. Let's grab a drink real quick. All right. Yes. I need to get mesh bone information out, which means we gotta go to the mesh loader. Mesh, it's not this, it'll be like, we got in here, we got normals, tangents, faces, bones. Here we go, AI bone. What's his name? Okay. So we're gonna have like a that's basically what it looks like. So this will be the list of bones for the mesh, which correspond to. Yeah. That was the bone. That's actually pretty easy because it's just, yeah. Fish bones. Star P bone. I need that, where was it? Yeah, scene loader. This, I need this to be in like a third location. Okay. Okay. Right, what's going on? Okay. Okay, that's it. Okay. Okay, so we now have mesh bones. Let's see what they come out for. It'll be like 0 and 1, basically, I imagine. Of course, correspond to scene armature. Bone that and bone that. And for animation. Armature bone and armature bone 1. Amazing. Okay. Now to start getting all this together in a way to work. Okay, what we're going to need is, of course, we're going to need some public stuff. We need like the faux armature. We only have nodes, and we go down by nodes, don't we? Okay, whatever. Here we've got the mesh bones. Armature equals that, animation equals that. Then we'll have the bones. Holy crap, it's just not having any. Okay, let's just reboot the editor. Okay. Mesh bones equals that. Now, what we're going to do is. Simulation clock. Okay, what we can do with the simulation clock is we can divide it by the total time from starting from zero, which is this. It starts at zero. Okay. This is going to be a bit of terrible fun. Which we'll be putting in here somewhere. Do you want to do it here? Yeah, I'll just do it here. At first, I can start with the two. Okay, we only have two bones for now. Okay, I need a bunch of buffers for this. Up, 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 up. Per frame data, da, 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 this stuff. Perhaps I can do, what was it? Camera descriptor pool, right? In a similar fashion to this, animation pool. It's going to be a bunch of fun, I'm sure. We do need to figure out this in case it's like a single one or two bone. Well, what if it's like a 256 and it's only like three bones? Yeah. Or say this is 64. Do I have to? Okay, what I do need is these, at least. Uniform, buffer, and this. Does it have to be part of the same, like, if it's part of the same descriptor set? I'm not sure if they have to be part of the same. If I have to, like, if I have two uniform buffers, a model matrix buffer and a bone buffer, do I have to have them as part of the same descriptor? Even, or can I have them as a different descriptors on the same descriptor set? Don't know. I'll find out sooner or later. So we're gonna have basically this. Just this for the moment, because I think, okay, at first we need the animation information. This will be very similar to the camera pools thing. What we got going on here? Got a bunch of all this stuff. Okay, that's great. Actually, we'll need two sets, won't we? Maybe? Buffers and descriptor pools. Okay, let's try two. We'll have one set for buffers, model buffers, model descriptor pools. And we'll have one for the bone data. So, yeah. That. I'm trying to do it like that. So that's, well, these are all uniforms, right? These are all going to be uniform types. So we've got 10, 24. Create for that. Do the same thing down here. For bone descriptor pools. Don't have all this quite yet. it's just, yeah. Where's the deinitialize? Here it is. Okay, that's terrible. This is the hackiest thing ever. Of course, it'll only just barely work. Then what I want to do is similar to this. Come on, bone buffers, damn it. So we've got going on here. There's only going to be one for now. We'll work off of that. Keep it simple. Okay, that's great. Size of GLM. Four. Fantastic. Now we need the other one for this. I need to import the bone information. I absolutely do. I hate this 1080p screen. It's so I can't. Don't have the space to put everything I need. Would I be okay for the moment? I just need bone information, which means I just need like this armature nodes. Would it be that? No, it'd be from this. It's these guys. Yes. Animation? No. We have the bones. Now we want to go through if. Basically same thing as this, but we want to change it up for bone uniform. Is less than... No, because it's up to 64 right now. Jeez. Or, no, just bones at size for the moment. Bones at size times bones dot size. And I could shrink it down to like 3, like a vec 4, a quaternion, and a vec 4, something like that. But I'm not. Burn, burn, great. Then much like this counter descriptor pool, we're just going to have to go through them. Actually, for the moment, it's just a model matrix. Okay, we need to map. Set the descriptor pool. Map 4. RP matrix. Data. Actually, that's right. This can't be right. This would have to move up by a certain amount of... Oh, no, no. Yeah. No? Yeah, this is wrong. Right? Matrix... Yeah, this is very wrong. This would have to be something else. This would basically have to be offset, wouldn't it? Rather it be like uint 8t like that. Pbuffer data. And then this. Yeah, that'll work. There we go. That should work instead. Just make sure it does before I go any crazy. Go any crazier. This doesn't even work. Build in yet, anyways. But I really need to have like a second camera to be able to test it, wouldn't I? No, because the byte size is 4. What I need to test it is a crappier GPU that has a different alignment type. I might have an old MacBook to test that on. But I'll do that later. Uniform. Go through, then we'll unmap it. Turn res at the end. Okay. That's great. Okay, we want to set. The offset is zero for now. We're just going to go, for this, we can go through, add a GLM at 4 rate, actually. Because we only have the 1 right now. For each bone. Put the bones in at each location within. Then afterwards, we're going to want to do the descriptor set. Okay, I need to get the descriptor set stuff out. Everything always, trying to do anything, always explodes into a whole bunch of pieces. Model and bone state matrices, wonderful, that's what I'm looking for. I want to be able to get out the descriptor set for that. Index. Not the bindings. I need to do the bindings separately. That all the way down here when we bring it in. Projection. Ugh. Okay. We allocate one descriptor set. Okay, we got the set. Now we do what's this right set? This would be writing the entirety of the set, wouldn't it? Or would it? As I actually might want to split these guys up. Might be better to have like the model matrix and the bone state matrices be separate rather than occupying the same spot. And then move these guys down by one. I think. That might actually be better. I'm going to do that. So instead of this, see where this is going to error out. Did I screw that up? I think I screwed this up somewhere. Yeah, didn't mean to add that. So we can kind of use a mix and match between model matrices and bone state matrices, because realistically there should only be a few bone states. I don't want to have them necessarily tied with model matrices at the same time. I have enough like extra binding or layout set locations. I think the minimum is like 16 now. I'm only using 8 of them. Layouts, that is. Realistically, I don't think I'll be requiring much more than that. Mesh boned. Okay. Yeah. Something like that. So it'll be set one and set two with binding of. Matching binding and set locations. Up to max bones. Okay. Animations, we'll go through with that. So it's not that, it's just the bone states which I care about here. So just bone set layout. That way, they can also be they can work in parallel as well if they're not necessarily tied together. In my mind, anyways. Okay, now we want to write the descriptor set that we've created. It'll be bone uniform dot buffer. offset of 0, size of that times bones.size. We got the binding of, which is the same. No, it's not. Set buffer info, which is this, which is correct. We write the set, we unmap it. Okay, we're good on this. I'm not going to do this model matrix yet. I'm going to do this though. Now we'll set that to 2 for the moment as well. We're not going to do bone transform, we're going to do bone times. Oh, no. 0 and 1, so bone matrices times in bone indices of I times that. Nice. That'll be the by default the starting offset matrices. Should have basically come out to 1 as well. So, come down way down here. We need to actually add this. Terrible, ugly code conglomeration is only this terrible, so I can figure out how to get it working. Then I will refactor it. Famous last words, of course. Same as these two, except it's not the layout projection view matrix, it's the bone state matrices. Okay. Time is what? Sorry, but I don't think so. I don't think that'll work quite that well. Mesh bones, mesh. Ah! Yeah, I didn't think so. Where is the time? This. Not quite. Dot count the milliseconds times 1000 point F. Rather divided by 1000. Whatever, it doesn't really matter right now. We generate this, and then we're going to... find the descriptor set. Okay, let's just make this all public so I can actually read it. Bind point graphics. We're going to not this layout, but oh yeah, the pipeline layout is correct, yes. Set one for count of one. So this would be the model matrix, which we don't have. So we need to pass in in the dummy set, it's part of the pipeline. No, whoops, reading the thing. Descriptor set with a dynamic offset of 0 and a null pointer. Okay. And then this is the one I'm interested in, dummy, or rather set equals. Where's the descriptor set? Of course, it's set every time, so we'll just say M set. Okay, we do similar to this, except we're at binding location 2 for count of 1, null pointer. Yes, that's great. Meshbone.vertex. We already have this. This bone state matrices as well. All right, it's going to blow apart at the seams. I'm 100% sure, but it'll be interesting to see what it is. Looks like a bit of an elongated box now. And secondarily, it didn't actually destroy itself. Interesting. Let's bring up the render dock. Let's see what we got. For data inside. Actually, can I? No, I don't know. I wouldn't even be able to reach it anyways. Launch. Amazing. So we got the scripture set. This is the dummy one. Buffer 3, pipeline layout that, P descriptor set 1270, that's great. Mesh viewer stuff. Inbone indices, that's great. Inbone weights, that's great. And what we got, vertex shader out. Yeah, makes sense. Was it? Descriptor set that. Yeah, that's great. Who do you have? Nope, wrong one. Pipeline state? Is this what I'm looking for? Yes, maybe vertex shader, armature, UBO. Was it armature UBO? Yeah, it would have been armature EBO. Buffer 283, great. 283, great. Size of that, so. I just say, like, mat 4? Is that something that works? Yes, it is. Maybe? Unless I screwed up how I'm doing model matrices now. Unless by default it's rotating by like 90 degrees. Okay, well let's look at what the matrices are, even then. One, zero, 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 negative one, zero. 0, 1, 0. These are column matrix, or column major. So that would mean that this is, and then 1, 0, 1. Sorry, no, last one, this one. 3, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, hold on. No, yeah, 0, 1, 0, 1. Okay. So the data I did get in is correct. Can I actually read this? No, this one. Okay, I guess. Interesting. I guess it is right. It looks a bit lopsided. Like it's just not quite as square as it. Like that's way more square than it is from the side right now. Unless I just kind of mucked up the model a bit. Perhaps we'll see when I place the bones with animation data. I'm hoping, anyways. Oh, but that's true. There's also a base model transform I'm not even using either for the mesh. Whatever. Okay, I'm gonna hold it there 2 hours, 2 hours, 10 minutes. And I got something going through. I'm not sure if it's right. Next time I'll actually try to apply animation data to the bones and pass it through. Hopefully get something animating. Cheers. Okay, so last time I got it up to putting some garbage bone matrices in. Actually, I want. Okay. If I set bone matrices to just two sets of that. Okay, animation. Bone. What's that look like? Does that look like a proper cube again? It looks like a proper cube again. So it is specifically these weird bone matrices that's going weird and whatever. Yeah, it's squashed of some sort. Okay, I'll assume that's supposed to be that way. Okay, what I'm going to do now is the animation, right? The animation currently uses the exact same layout, bone 0 to bone 1, so I'll use that as a shortcut for the moment. Animation. Okay. We will. Okay, what's time? Hoping this will be seconds. Really hoping it'll be seconds. So time. Duration. Animation. Duration. Okay. Ticks per second. Crap. It's oh no, it was like one. So this should be fine. One tick per second or so. The asymp thing. It was specific order, of course. Go to this. It is AI node animation, specifically keys. Yeah, there we go. The usual scaling rotation translation. Okay. Okay, for do like an animation where it's animation. Okay, we're doing as long as at least one of these channels isn't empty. Okay. Basically same thing. I'll cast for Quaternions. Yes. Okay, and then the final transform we're going to have is... Okay. Scaling to rotation to translation. Else, we'll do that for the moment. And then that. Let's see what this looks like. Ah, yes. I did not pass in the animation. Well, it's doing something. What precisely, I'm not entirely sure. And I guess that's the end of the animation right there. Okay. It's a modular mod. What's the remainder? C++. I thought it was modulo. It is percentage. I'm sorry, what? Time's not constant. Oh, yeah, it's... I guess, okay, maybe it doesn't quite work that way. Divide by that. Okay. Time minus time times time divided by that. We'll give the leftover time and then it'll restart repeating, right? it just freezes after a while. Okay, cool. What? Hold on. Okay, while time is greater than okay. Can I figure out how to do time correctly? Okay, I need to fix the culling, of course. Culling. Part of the fragment part. There you go. Cull the back. Unless these are reversed. I think this is backwards. Yeah. Okay, this is a very weird looking thing. It's obviously not right. I mean, the original cube was correct. Let's open this file up. What does it look like? Can I do the animation and kind of hook it up, or? No. There you go. This is what it's supposed to look like. I mean, that doesn't really look like at all what we're looking at. Well, it could. So not like any, can I add like some scaling? What's the scale look like? This is a really terrible thing. This cube. Let me see if I can make something a bit more, something I can actually figure out what I'm looking at first. Okay, what's this? Tall animated cuboid. Can I open this up with Blender? No, Blender does not like that, opening that up. Dang. Okay. Okay. What if I just open it up with Blender by importing it? Okay. Delete what's on there. Delete that. File, import collider. Okay, let's actually see if I can just copy this. Okay, it's there. Bam. Okay. Delete. And what are you? You're a tall animated cuboid, supposedly. Now that looks far more. Oh, is that it? Oh, okay. It does repeat. That's something I can probably actually figure out what I'm doing with. It's a lot more, yeah. Okay, we'll try to work with this guy instead. Tall animated cuboid. We've got a number of items. We need to know the indices we have. How many bones? Oh, I don't know how many bones we have either. Number of indices. Tell me. So we're going to put that in down here. Where is it? There it is. We're not going to bind the bone data or the model data, matrix data yet. Instead, we're going to, for the moment, go back to using just the plain old mesh vertex one. I have the data, even though we don't use it. I wonder if the front and back, if, well, let's see in a moment. What does it look like? Or does it just crash? It looks like a cube. I guess it's backwards as well, front bit, right? Because if I go back, then it's, I don't know why all the things I created up have backwards culling, but they do. Whatever. Okay, fine. Call the front. Amazing. It's a large cube. Let's reinstitute this stuff. Mesh boned, great. Okay. Let's have a look at the number of mesh bones we have. So I can actually remake the... We have four. Upper middle, lower middle, bottom, core. Okay, we have four. Let's remake this with four bones. VK animation. Bones at size. Goes through all four, I presume, looks like. Okay. What's going to Excellent. Massive failure. Oh, I didn't re-enable these guys. So several descriptor sets were just empty. Pointing probably to garbage data. Okay. Not quite. Kind of hideous monstrosity. Actually, okay, maybe. It's currently in order, right? Right. Maybe it has to be like times the previous transform. So bones are currently in order, right? Armature upper, armature middle, armature lower. And probably the same thing for the animation channels, right? Bottom, lower, upper, and upper. Okay. Starts off with the identity, then becomes this. This equals times transform. It's already there. So like it piles on top rather, maybe it's like additive rather than what I'm doing. That's actually quite close. It's a lot closer. Obviously, something is still iffy about it, but that is significantly closer to a tall cue ball. It's just like way scaled down on one axis. And twist it around a bit. So this is the bottom. That's the top that flails about. Maybe I'm just importing these wrong a little bit. Like the bone information. No, I'm not even using the bone information. This is the animation information specifically that I'm pulling in. X, Y, Z, position keys, scaling keys. Is it rotation? W, X, Y, Z. Keys, scaling, rotation. No, it's all right. Then the animation adds channel to the end. Maybe I have to do something with the offset matrix. Okay, what if animation, we then transform. Okay, the animation is based on that. So all we have to do is like whatever's in that P buffer data. Equals what? Okay, put this back here at the end. So let's say it's equals, okay, no, maybe not. Bones. For I dot offset times the transform. Give that a go. Because the bones must be used for something. to offset from the base armature. What's this? This is actually significantly worse. Okay, what the other way? Transform the animated piece times the offset matrix. Because that elongated it more. What I needed to do is the opposite. Oh, whoa, here we go. There we go. That is... I closed Blender, didn't I? Yeah, okay. Delete, delete, delete. Import... there, there, to there, to tall animated cuboid. Put that in the side, down the other side, and run that. Okay. It's like here. So it'd be like from here instead. Yeah, okay. Okay, I got it. I got it. I got it. It's working. Oh my god. Excellent. 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 I duct taped this together with some string and duct tape. The red-green Canadian way. Fantastic. Okay, animations. I'm just going to gaze upon my work in despair. Not in the Ozymandias way, of course, of look at my how great my work is compared to yours, but look at how barely strung together this is. But it is progress. Okay. So the only thing I'd have to do is add in the model matrix, which really is rather trivial since it's basically the same thing as the camera UBO at this point. And it is currently on a different set and binding as well. So that saves quite a bit of effort there as well. Okay, maybe I'll actually cut this short and splice it with the other one. The other one's already 2 hours, so 2.5 hours. Yeah, I'm going to do that. I'm going to splice this with the other one. Cheers.